Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the 2023 Oklahoma Learning Innovation Summit. I'm here with Lora Pezzell. She's presenting, collaborating in a live Zoom meeting. So how are you today, Lora?
I'm doing great.
Great. Please get started. Thank you.
Well, thanks so much for the introduction. My name is Lora Pezzell, and I work at the Center for E-Learning and Connected Environments at the University of Central Oklahoma. And I'm hoping also that my colleague, Jay Hargett, will be joining us as we've had some issues after this storm that we've all been through. I myself had experienced two rounds of hail at my home, so it was pretty scary, but I'm very grateful and thankful that it wasn't a tornado, obviously. But my heart goes out to all of the folks that have been impacted by it, and especially those who have lost lives in the town of Cole. So I just wanted to say that. So basically, this meeting is about collaborating in live Zoom meetings. And so, you know, you think about Zoom and all the things that we've used it for. We used it during the pandemic, we depended on it. But the thing is that there have been many, many upgrades that I'm sure some of you are not aware of. So that's what this meeting is about. And so by the end of this learning session, you should be able to know how to create a poll in Zoom, how to use it at your next live Zoom meeting, and then also be able to describe the various tools available, and they're easy to implement. So the first thing we're going to do is just start with a poll. So I have four questions here. So if you can please fill those out. There's Jay. Welcome, Jay. So we have Stacy, if you can fill that in for us. So the first question is, have you ever used polls in Zoom? Has some snazzy new whiteboard with templates? Have you ever tried the whiteboards? Have you ever tried playing a game with the amazing choice of emojis? And what about captions? Should you use them during live meetings, yes or no? Okay, so we'll go ahead and just continue while everyone is filling out the poll. Oh, Rhonda's here. So Rhonda, welcome. We have a poll about using Zoom, and there are a few questions. If you wouldn't mind filling them in, that would be super.
Okay.
Yes. And Jay is going to help me with the chat as well, if anybody has any questions in the chat.
Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone had a relatively safe evening. It was a lot of fun.
Okay, so let's see. Let's go ahead and end the poll, so it'll give us the results. Okay, so let's see. All righty then. So I'll be showing you some new and exciting fun things then. So this is how you set up the poll. I'm going to just explain. It's very, very easy. You need to go to your Zoom profile. And then in your Zoom profile, what you do is you select meetings. And then you select polls and quizzes. And that's how you can create your poll and also the quiz. So there, and what's really exciting is now the quizzes have all kinds of different varieties that you can use for competency-based learning. Now, since we are in higher education, we always love to have models and things, you know, to kind of have the flow of the meeting go. And so the one that I'm going to share with you just briefly is called Joseph Keller's ARCS model of motivation. And I will show you a little diagram of that on my whiteboard soon. And so what this theory is, it's about keeping your audience attention by either perception or inquiry. And so there's just some basic steps, and they have to do with active participation, which is so important. You can have role plays, hands-on practice, just different ways to keep students engaged during the meetings, using humor, obviously using humor with caution, lighthearted stories to grab the attention of the audience, funny dad jokes and stuff like that. And then there's conflict. Think about statements, you know, that might be the opposite of what the learners know, just to kind of grab their attention to get them off of their phones and playing Candy Crush. And then variety. And so variety is to grab their attention by using various media. And so that's what we're going to do with using the emojis and things like that and using the whiteboard. And so the first thing is, that I'm going to go over is how to use the breakout rooms. So breakout rooms are really important because that gives you an opportunity for, unfortunately on this particular Zoom tool, I don't see the breakout rooms, but I will just tell you what they're used for. So they are used for larger meetings. So like this is a small meeting, but it is being recorded and shared for later use. And so if you're thinking about your larger meeting, say like you had 50 people in the meeting, that's when be a good time to use a breakout room. And so you would have, you'd break them up into say like maybe groups of four people together. And to do that, you go to profile settings, then you go to meetings, and then you go to breakout rooms. And then you have to make sure to enable allow host to enable participants to breakout rooms when scheduling. Okay, so the next step that we're going to do is we're going to share the whiteboard. There have been many upgrades in the whiteboards. Okay, so let's see. And when you open up your whiteboard, it will ask you some questions. Collaborating, users are granted access, or presenting. You can open it in presentation mode only. And then also, if you want users to have access, so after the meeting, I will say yes. So now I'm going to open my board. Okay, so this is the whiteboard, and there are so many exciting and new tools available within these whiteboards and templates. And one of the things that I really like is that you can use post-it notes and things like that. So the first thing that I'm going to teach you all is how to use the sticky notes. So if you look at the board, on the left-hand side, there's a toolbar, and you will see it has various little emblems, and I'll tell you what they all mean. So the first one is select, and the next one is draw. Then you have shapes, you have lines, you can use text, you can use a sticky note, templates, you can actually upload an image if you want, or you can use more tools. So the first thing is to, we're going to upload sticky notes. So each person will upload a sticky note by clicking on the sticky note, and they're going to put in their name, where they are from, and where they work.
I don't know if I can do that. Well, that's great.
I wanted to keep the instructions simple. So when you open it, you will find that on the sticky note, it has an option to reduce the size of the text under auto. So that's where you can make it smaller. Okay, now you can also write on it, what's your favorite flavor of ice cream? So you click on auto, and then that's going to bring the different font sizes.
You click on auto. There's none of that on the phone.
Yeah, so 24 is what I'm using. My favorite ice cream, it's too small. So what happened just now is I clicked on the Zoom button to make it bigger. So you can do that as well. You can zoom in and zoom out as the person who's running the meeting. There's also a bar on the bottom that you can scroll back and forth. So I just wanted to show you how that looks. Okay, so let's see. Christella likes chocolate chip cookie dough. Jay likes all ice creams. Rhonda, what kind of ice cream do you like? Stacy, Let's see, let me add mine. Tracy, you got to fill out yours. I'm going to use blue. Let's see.
Yeah, Tracy, there are those of us who do wear glasses. I cannot see that.
I'm working on it. Give me a minute.
Yeah, I'm going to make this bigger for us. There.
Can you guys hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. Well, I have good internet, but I don't know what I'm doing. I think I can send you... I think I said hello on the sticky thing. I'm trying to do it from my phone because so many of the
we see that. Things,
and this is not easy on a phone. If I were on my laptop, I'd be able to do it really well. So I think I'll just do this next time from, I mean, when I do my Zoom meetings, I do them from my laptop, but I thought I'd do this from a phone for fun, but it's not fun from my phone.
It's not going to be fun on the phone, but yeah. it'll be better on a either laptop, desktop, or even a tablet. Tablets work pretty good too.
Right, because that's how I'll set up. But thank you for your patience. And that's how I set them up. But thank you. This is fun.
So this is a great way to keep your students engaged. You could draw there's a drawing tool if you have the opportunity to draw actually on your monitor, which I don't, but I think that's when you could actually use this like drawing tool. Yeah, so you can use like a highlighter and maybe highlight things, change the color of it. Let's see, highlighter, and then you could erase it. You can write in text. And you can save these boards too. And so it's a little bit hard in this amount of time to show you what the templates look like. So I will show you one that I have created. Let me see if I can find it here. I think I need to go over here. Here it is.
I like the thumbs up thing. That's cool.
Now I'm going to zoom out so you can see it. So now this is going to show instead of the sticky notes. What's really neat is they have so many great templates. And so this can be used in various Zoom meetings. Like say, for example, you want to have an icebreaker and you want to do something like, what country are you from? And so in certain meetings that I've been in with people that are from around the world, they use that map. And so I think someone has their Zoom open in two different windows. That's why it's creating an echo. Okay. And so what I did is I created this template ahead of time of Joseph Keller's ARCS model. So you can see about this theory. Here are the four steps: active participation, using humor. And then we have using variety, and then also conflict. So because of my personality, I'm the kind of person who likes to avoid conflicts at all costs. I think I might be better off just trying to think of a contrary statement. Okay, so now we're going to go on to the next one. Now I'm going to share my screen and I will show you a couple of the templates before I go on to the next. See how we're doing on time, okay, Tracy?
Yes.
Okay.
No worries.
There's a question in the chat that they can't see the model. I think the model looks like sticky notes. There was a green background.
Okay, let me just share my screen. So here are some of the amazing templates that you can use. Now, when you're sharing your screen, you should make sure to move the toolbar down. And you can also, if you have dual monitors, you can move your chats over to the other side of the screen. So this one is called the stop, start, continue retrospective. So this talks about different brainstorming ideas, like what should we stop, what should we start, what should we continue? And then we have the problem, root cause, and solution. That's another brainstorming tool that you can use. And then we have where are you from? So as I mentioned before, this one was a really neat template to use for a meeting from people from different countries. And everybody put a pin on the places that they're located from. It was actually really neat to see people from all over the world in the meeting. And then the last one that I'll show you today is one of my favorites, which is called the SWOT analysis. And so the SWOT analysis is good for brainstorming and strategies, because you can talk about your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats for different things, for personal growth, for tutoring. I used it in the past for tutoring students, for your department, and things like that. Now I'm going to stop sharing. And before I turn it over to Jay, I'm going to show you some of these other tools that are available. And the next one is going to be the reactions. So if everyone clicks on the reactions, they will see that there are so many different options here now, not just raising your hand or a smiley face. So you're going to click all the way over to the three dots. And you will see that there is just a plethora of all these different emojis that you can use. So if you look across the top, you'll see there's smileys, there are animals, foods and drink, activities, travel, objects, and symbols. So I want everyone to pick their favorite animal emoji. So I picked mine, I picked a cow. Is everyone good with that tool? We're able to open it okay? So what's fun about this is you can play various games. For example, you could play Pictionary, and that's where the host selects some of the emojis, and then she will send it, or he will send it to the participants, and they have to act out whatever that particular emoji is, you know, without... without saying anything. For example, if you're trying to pretend to be a cat, you'd have to just go, or if you're a snake, of course, it's hard to do it without saying anything. Okay, now I want everyone to select their favorite food. So click on the food icon. It could be fruit, it could be carbs, it could be fast food, it could be even coffee, like right now. I wouldn't mind having more coffee. And Jay's gonna have pizza. And Scarlett's having a pineapple. Oh, I love pineapples. Okay, one thing to keep in mind regarding the reactions is we have to always think about DEI, diversity, equity, and inclusion. And so when you're using these, you have to keep that in mind, because I noticed that there's definitely some improvements needed in Zoom for what they have represented for faces in diversity. Okay, now, since we're on this upgraded toolbar, there's also this apps here. Just gonna make a quick note. To look into that, there is even an AI note taker, which is pretty interesting. And then if you click on the more with the three dots, you can go to live on Facebook, live on Workplace, live on YouTube, and any of those streamers. And so that's a really neat tool to have and it'd be accessible for you. Okay, so now I'm turning it over to Jay for tips on great videos.
Okay, Lora, I'm actually seeing the template.
Oh, okay, let me close it.
Because mine's more visual. Mine's going to be camera fun. So let me go ahead and get started while we're doing that. Mm-hmm. First of all, if you notice when Lora was speaking there, I think you're going to have to, let's see.
Yeah, hit stop sharing and it's still showing it.
Hit the carrot.
Mm-hmm. Event sharing. Let's see.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
There we go. Okay. All right. So here I am, bright as day. And I wanted to start with some little quick tips on the technology. First of all, lighting. As you can see on my forehead, I got that little bitty white dot here. Well, that's from the two lights that I have left and right. Lighting is really important in order to be able to do this, be able to communicate face to face via that camera lens that I'm pointing at. You have to be able to have sufficient lighting in order to be able to show the eyebrows or the bags under my eyes or the fact that I didn't trim my mustache properly or, you know, 5 o'clock shadow. You need to make sure that you're aware of all of that. The other thing is that windows are evil and should be destroyed in our lifetime. They will definitely tear up any kind of Zoom broadcast that you're going to try to make by doing the old Rembrandt thing where all you see is half the face and the other side is excluded in darkness. So if you want to step your game up visually, invest in a $10 lamp or a $20 circle light that would be right around where the camera is. That way it gives you full frontal video right to your face and highlights, you know, the fact that you have a face. The other thing is backgrounds. As you can see, we've got a background that Lora and I have gotten from our institutions. These are, you know, up here. Yeah, they're all branded with the logo and what have you. And the reason why you use those is because of the fact that, number one, it looks better. And I'm going to change this to this. Okay. While that's okay, it's certainly going to be better than, I'm going to go into the background here and show you. Yuck. Yeah. The other thing you want to take into consideration is the fact that, you know, I've got a bunch of stuff back here and that's just paneling. However, if you have some really nice things in your house and they're right behind you, well, I almost hate to say this, but in this times that we are living in, it becomes an issue associated with cognitive load. Or even worse, you have really nice things and you've just shown them where they are and what they are. So, you know, perhaps maybe, just maybe, this would be a little bit better. One other thing that you should also take in consideration, get rid of that, is that get a good microphone. Okay. As you can tell, I have a good one. It is a professional line microphone, but you don't have to spend an awful lot of money in order to get really good sound quality. This is a microphone. We normally assign microphones. We use the Blue Yetis. This is a little bit higher grade microphone because that's kind of the gig that I have. But the better your sound quality, the better the cognitive load that you're going to have in order to be able to express yourself clearly and consistently, not only live, but also on the recording. Because when somebody comes back and wants to review or whatever, you'll be able to have a good quality recording that anyone can use that's in the class. The other thing also is on the camera, you should really try to get an app. And this app is a very fascinating thing that allows you to do things with your camera. For instance, this is a Logitech C920E. What are you going to know from brand names? But you can always get an app, even third party, that allows you to do things like this. Yeah, like this. Or you get something that allows you to be able to do something like this. Or even this. So if you'll get, if you'll invest in one of these little apps, and some of them might even be free, you can definitely tweak the way things look and how they look, and be able to not have to spend an awful lot of money on, theatrical lighting. The lighting that I've got, their garage clip-on lights, the ones you can clip onto anything with a bulb in it. That's what I got. So you don't have to spend an awful lot of money. And finally, have some water nearby, because if your voice tends to get a little bit of croaky like mine does, you need some hydration in there. So keep that out of shot, but have it handy. Bottle of water is always a good thing. And before you ask, no, vodka does not count. Okay. So you don't have to spend a fortune. And, finally, and this will be the end of it, it gets better. I know I sound like I do this all the time. Okay, yeah, I do. But it does get better over time. And, mistakes might seem weird at first, but they get better. So, the more you exercise that muscle, the stronger it's going to get. So that's really about it. If you have any questions, chat them in and I'll be happy to answer them, or email me, teams me, whatever. I'll be more than happy to drill down into this subject matter ad nauseum. So thank you, Laura.
Thank you, Jay. And we have the handout uploaded into the Zoom lobby, so you can get your handout there with our contact information. And I just want to thank everyone for joining us. And it's been a lot of fun. And I love Zoom meetings.
Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Jay. It's a great session today. Thank you.